90% of parents think their children read and do math on grade level or better. The latest results of the nation's report card show that most parents are wrong. In 2022, fourth and eighth graders' NAEP achievement fell compared to before the pandemic. Students experienced the steepest drop in the history of the math tests, and students lost nearly as much progress in reading. Everyone's achievement dropped. Boys and girls, white, black, and Hispanic students, students in poverty and wealthy students. Top performers dipped too. But most of all, students who struggled before the pandemic fell much, much further behind. For them, the pandemic has been more of a tipping point than a single push. Math and reading scores have been falling for years for the students in the lowest 25%. Now, 38% of 8th graders and a quarter of 4th graders can't meet NAEP's lowest benchmark in math. In practical terms, that means, for example, that less than 60% of 4th graders can tell whether a whole number is even or odd. Only 44% of 8th graders can solve a problem using division, down from half in 2019. In more than 20 years, we haven't had this many children struggling this much in math. Students held their ground a little bit more in reading, but you'd still have to go back to 2003 to find more than a third of fourth graders who can't read at even a basic level. They couldn't find the main idea stated in a text or infer simple things about story characters or plot. More readers are failing in our eighth grade classrooms than at any time since 1994. Among other things, this means that only half of 8th graders can recognize a key question answered in a text. That's significantly fewer than 2019. What does this mean for our children? For one thing, it means kids are not bouncing back from 2 years of school disruptions and stress. In 2020, 4th graders who took NAEP in 2022 were halfway through 2nd grade when the pandemic hit. 8th graders were still adjusting to middle school. Many had attended virtual or socially distanced classrooms for months or even years. And it's clear those disruptions set students back in math and reading. It also means students will need major systemic interventions to get back on track. In NAEP surveys, students still feel anxious and their teachers feel overworked. Each state tests students against its own standards, but NAEP uses a single set of standards nationwide. It tests big groups that represent each state and 26 of the nation's biggest city school districts. No one student takes the whole NAEP math or reading test, but taken together, the results show what American students know and can do. To dig into more details about the NAEP results, please see our coverage at educationweek.org.